Hello students, I made this today's video is regarding the stress check again. Because what we did in the last lecture is we have taken the values of allowable compressive stress as per IS 456, but from the exam point of view and as per the numerical requirement, as we are doing the design for pre-stressed concrete structure, we need to follow the IS 1343-2012. So that's why in this today's session we are going to find out the values of allowable compressive stress as per IS 1343-2012. So let's begin. So step number 10 already we have studied in the last video. So in this check, actually what we did, we compare two values. First of all we are going to calculate the values of compressive stresses by using the various theories. So the actually developed compressive stresses in the structure we calculated already in the last lecture, and that value we get as 6.99 MPa, right? The maximum compressive stress at the top of the slab is 6.99. And this actually developed compressive stress we compared with allowable stress value. Now this is the point where we are going to change the procedure. Means we are going to take the values of compressive stress as per IS 1343-2012. So how we get that allowable value from IS 1343-2012? So we get that value as per figure number 7 of IS 13-2012. So here I have taken the screenshot of figure number 7. So what that figure number 7 tells us, it gives the value of compressive stresses. So computation of maximum permissible compressive stress in flexure due to the final pre-stress. So that value is given in the figure 7. So what is this figure 7? So it's a relation. It's a relation between the grade of concrete and the compressive stress, allowable compressive stress for two zones, that is zone 1 and zone 2. So the grade of concrete which we used for our design is M40. So it lies in between the M30 and M60, because at extreme left we have M30 grade concrete and at extreme right we have M60. So our M40 grade is something in between this M30 and M60. Okay. So to get that allowable value, we should know the value of FCK. Yes, we know that for our case, we take the value of grade of concrete or the FCK as M40. Again, we need to select the zone. Means we need to go for the zone 1 or zone 2. So the details of the zone 1 and zone 2 are there in the IS 1343-2012. But briefly we are going to see as we are going to follow the zone 1. We are going to follow the zone 1. Why we are going to follow that zone 1? We are going to see from the definition. See here, what is the representation of zone 1? Zone 1, it falls in a part of that section where the compressive stresses are not likely to increase in surface. Okay, means we are considering that whatever values of compressive stresses are there, that are not going to increase beyond the surface condition. Means whatever surface condition we are going to consider, the value is not going to increase beyond that. And that is what the correct assumption for the designing, because when it is going to increase the surface condition, definitely it is going to make a trouble for our design. So that's why we are following the zone 1. So for zone 1, we have the values for allowable stresses as 0.41 FCK and 0.35 FCK, and we want it for M40 grade concrete. So for that reason, what we are going to do, we are going to do the interpolation. Means we don't have any other option. So here I have taken this table for linear interpolation, where in first column I have taken it as the I have taken the grade of concretes M30, M40, M60, and in column 2 we have allowable compressive stress. So let's call this grade of concrete as A1, A2, A3 and allowable compressive stresses as B1, B2 and B3. For M30, we have 16.4 allowable compressive stress, and for M60 we have 14 MPa allowable compressive stress, and we need to calculate it for M40. So this is what the linear interpolation formula. Okay, so when we put these values of A1, A2, A3 and B1, B2, B3 values in this interpolation formula, and when we do the calculation, we get the answer as 15.6 Newton per mm square. Means the allowable value of compressive stress is 15.6. So see here, as per the IS 1343 2012, the allowable compressive stress value we get as the more than that which IS 456 allows, because as per 456 that value is 13, and here as per IS 1343 we get that value as 15.6. means we can comment that whatever design we did, that design is okay, hence okay, right? So in this way we are going to take the check for stresses as per IS 1343 2012. So do remember that whenever we are going to do the design for pre-stressing, we are going to take the check for stresses as per IS 1343 2012. Thank you.